What's up, guys? Welcome to part 8 of this 10-part video series. The last part we talked about data points and ultimately what numbers we need to get. This video, we're going to hop back into the mechanics and we're going to be talking about from position 6 into impact and what has to happen for us to hit those dynamics. So let's go do this thing. All right, so in this video, just like the first parts, we're gonna start out with talking about the knee structure, then we're gonna be talking about hip rotation, then we're gonna be talking about rib cage rotation, and then ultimately the arm structure and wrist conditions that we wanna see at the moment of impact. So let's hop into it. So the first thing, once we're in position 6, from here, I want you to focus in on my trail knee. We're gonna start seeing it kick a little bit more into internal rotation. The lead knee, we're starting to see extend as it's externally rotating as well. Now from there, when we're talking about the hip rotation, we're gonna see for a draw, right around position 6, the hip line is pretty much level or parallel to the ball target line. Once we get into impact, we're right around 15 degrees open. Now in terms of the rib cage rotation, again, just like we talked about earlier, we're really focusing in on the relationships between the sternum and the pelvis. So again, from here into impact, we're really making sure that we're keeping the sternum slightly behind the pelvis, but we're not overdoing it. Now from there, let's talk about the arm structure. When we talk about arm structure, I wanna see that the trail elbow is pretty much at its most bent position or the most narrow it's gonna get at the position in the golf swing. We're gonna see the lead arm is still relatively straight at this point. Working into impact from there, we're gonna see that the elbow starts extending slightly as we start seeing the lead elbow actually, if anything, bend a little bit. Now from here, in terms of the wrist conditions, this is probably one of the most important part, guys, as well, because again, we want to have a low dynamic loft and a good AOA. With the lead wrist, we're seeing it maintain its flexion. We're going to see that the trail wrist has some extension right here. We're also going to see that there's a little bit of a supinating move to make sure the club face is squaring up. And that is pretty much from position 6 into impact. Hopefully, guys, this helped. Best of luck and play some golf out there. Every time I'm leaving on you, ooh.